Ostende nobis Domine misericordiam tu. Domine exaudi orationem meam. Dominus vobis. Exaudi nos Domine Sancti Pater Omnipotens et Eterne Deus, et emitter redinieri Sanctum Angelum Tuum de Celis, cui custodiat, foveat, protegat, visited ad cui defendat omnes habitantes in hoc habitatum. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen. Thank you. gloria in excelsis Deo.
Omnipotens et misericordia Deus, de cuius munere venit, ut tibia fidelibus tui dignet laudabiliter serviatur. Tribue quesumus nobis, ut ad promissiones tuas sine offensione curamus. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus. Deus, qui non mortem sed penitentiam desideras peccatorum, populum tuum mater vertentem propitius respicem, ut dum tibi devotus existit, iracundi etue flagella, ab eo clementer amoveas. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobis. Sequentia sancti evangelii secundum Luca. In illo tempore dixit Iesus discipulis suis, beati oculi qui vident quae vos videtis. Dico enim vobis, quod molesi profete et reges voluerunt videre, quae vos videtis et non viderunt, et audire quae auditis et non audierunt. Et ecce quidam legis spiritus surrexit tantans illum et dicens, Magister, quid faciendo vitam aeternam possidebo. At ille dixit in eum in legge quid scribetum est, quomodo legis. Ille respondens dixit, Diliges Dominum Deum tuum, ex toto corde tuo et ex tota anima tua, et ex omnibus viribus tuis, et ex omnimen te tua, et proximum tuum sicut te ipsum. Dixit quae illi, recte respondisti, hoc facet vivi. Ille autem volens justificare se ipsum dixit ad Iesum, et quis est meus progressimus. Suscipiens autem Iesus dixit, homo quidam descendebant ab Jerusalem in Jericho, et incidit in latrones qui etiam despolia verunt eum. Et plagisim positis habierunt semivivo relictum. Accidit autem ut sacerdos quidam descenderent eadem via, et viso illo pareter ivit. Similiter et levita cum eset secus locum, et videret eum per transi. Samaritanus autem quidam iter faciens venit secus eum, et videns eum misericordia motus est, et apropians alligabit vulnereius in funden soleum et vinum, et in ponens illum in iumentum sum, Duresit in stabulum et cura meius egit. Et altera die protulit duos denarios et dedit stabulario et arit. Curam ilios abe, et quod cum quae supererogaveris, ego cum rediero credamati. Quis orum et rium videtur tibi progressimus fuisse illi, qui incidit in latrones. At ille dixit, qui fecit misericordiam in illum, et ait illi, Iesus, vade et tu facessimi.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Dear Canon, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, a certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho, and fell among robbers. Today our Lord gives us one of the most beautiful stories known to mankind, the story of the Good Samaritan. It is perfect. It says not too much, nor too little. First of all, our Lord isn't upset with this lawyer. Jesus responds to his question as a lawyer would, with another question. What is written in the law? How readest thou? The good Lord approaches him on his own ground. He doesn't disdain from answering. And it is already a lesson for us all. We need to approach people where they are and not where we would like them to be. There are so many out there who don't know the Ten Commandments. They haven't been catechized and they have a poor knowledge of right and wrong. Do we lord our knowledge over them and talk down to them? At work, do we keep airs of aloofness because we've been baptized and they are nothing more than pagans, or worse yet, Protestants? Yes, imagine this parable if it were given to us today. The Samaritans inspired scorn in the minds of the Jews. They were the heretics of that day and age. The Lutherans and Protestants, as it were, to those good Orthodox Hebrews. Yes, it was true. They did not have the fullness of the truth, exactly like our separated brethren. The Samaritans were mistaken about a great many things, and yet, it is not the priest, it is not the Levite who stops and cares for this poor man. It is the heretic, the Protestant of Jesus' day. Now you'll forgive me, but Jesus is not saying we should all become Protestants. Jesus knows that we have the fullness of the truth, but he asks us, which of these three, in your opinion, was neighbor to him that fell among the robbers? When we see others having a hard time in life, do we stop and give a hand? I'm sincere. Ask yourself this question. Do I stop on the road when I see someone with a car problem? Do I give a hand to those who are struggling? Or do I start making excuses and move on? Are we neighbor to those in their distress? Or do we, like the priest and the Levite, go and leave that poor man bleeding on the highway? Do we put ourselves in other people's shoes? Do we pray for those who are experiencing troubles? There was a saintly deacon living in the past century who has written wonderfully on our relationship we should have with Christ and seeing Christ in others. He has this to say, and I will quote it for you and finish there. Lord, what you ask is hard. It calls for courage and self-sacrifice, and I am weak. Please give me strength. Don't let me run away because of fear. Lord, live in me and act in me and love in me, and not in me alone, but in all of us, so that we may reveal no more your bloody, but your glorious face on earth. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen.
Credo in unum Deum.
Thank you.
omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobis. Nos tibi semper et ubique gratias agere. Domine sancte pater omnipotens aeterne Deus, qui cum unigenito filio tuo et spirito sancto unus eres Deus, unus es Dominus, non in unius singularitate personae, sed in unius Trinitate substantiae, quod enim de tua gloria revelant te credimus, hoc de Filio tuum, hoc de Spiritu Sanctum, sine differentia discretionis sanctimus. Ut in confessione vere sempiter neque deitatis, et in personis proprietas, et in essentia unitas, et in majestate adoretur equalitas. Quam laudant angelia de quia arcangeli, cherubim quoque arc seraphim, qui non cessant clamare quotidie una voce dicente. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus per recepti salutaribus moniti, et divina in institutione formati, auderemus dirice. Pater noster, qui es in excelis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimitimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobis.
Et cum spiritu.
Thank you.
miseria tu vestri omnipotens Deus, et dimissis peccatis vestris, perducat vos in vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum vestrorum, tribuat vobis omnipotens et misericordes Dominus.
Amen.
Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tolmit peccata mundi,
Domine nascum dignus in gesto tectum meum, sedam dum negrabo et labitur anima mea. Domine nascum dignus in gesto tectum meum, sedam dum negrabo et labitur anima mea. Domine nascum dignus in gesto tectum meum, sedam dum negrabo et labitur anima mea.
Thank you.
vivificet nos quesumus Domine eius participatio sancta mysteri, et pariter nobis expiationem tribuat et monimen. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus. Exaudi nos Deus salutaris noster, et populum tuum habira condie tue terroribus liberum, et misericordiae tue faclagitate secum. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Dominus
benedicat vos omnipotens Deus,
Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.